What's up, everyone? Today I'm giving you a free motion graphic for Premiere Pro. It's called Outline vs. Fill, and it allows you to create some pretty cool text animations. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to use this, as well as showing you how to create it from scratch. When you go to the product page, you'll notice that it says $3. If you want to help support me, you can simply purchase it for that price. If not, you can click the little link that says get this now for free, and that will show you how to get it for free. Let's get started. Hit that like button, let me know what you think down in the comments below if you want me to make more stuff like this, and subscribe, because I make new stuff all the time. So as soon as you download the MOGRT, all you have to do is open up Premiere and head on over to the Essential Graphics window. If you don't see that, go to the workspaces up here and head on over to Graphics. And then all you have to do is drag in the KH Outline vs. Fill MOGRT into the Essential Graphics window, or you can use this little button down here. Now you'll see that I have typed KH, because as soon as you type KH, that'll pull up all of mine. And we have this one called Outline vs. Fill. All you have to do is drag it into your timeline. And once you do, you'll see that it's already animated and it looks pretty cool. But here's the fun thing. This is a responsive design template. So if I want to increase the length of this, or if I drag this left out, the animation will slow down with that duration. Equally so, I can drag the right out, so then the animation is nice and slow. Now let's go through all these parameters so you can see what you can do. And if you also want to just jump right in right away and you don't care about learning how to make this, there's a how to use thing down here. So you can just read all of this and it will tell you how to do it. Up at the top, we have mode, which is changing how it works. So mode outline to fill means the text is going to start as an outline and then it's going to end at a fill. Equally so, the difference is fill to outline. So it's going to start as a fill and then go to outline. Now down here, you can change the text. So let's do Kyler Holland. And just like that, you can change it. You can adjust the scale as much as you want, and then you can also change the properties. So I'm gonna pick the font that I like, just like that. And then you can change whether it's regular or italic, and you can also like bold it, or you know, change it to all caps, do whatever you want. And here's the fun thing too, you can change the position. So if I want this to be lower down here or up higher, you can change that as well. Here is the cool part. So I'm just gonna decrease the length of this a little bit so we can kind of have something quick to work with. You can change how the animation is based on, or what the animation is based on. So you can do characters, so this is going to animate all the characters. And here's another little thing, characters excluding spaces. So if you have something with a lot of spaces, then it's going to exclude those spaces and only do the letters, so it's a little bit faster. And then here's characters again. And then you have words, so then this is going to animate word by word. So I have Kyler Holland is making free presets, and I select words. As you can see, it's going to animate by words, which is really cool. And with the click of a button, you can change the mode. So if you want it to be outlined to fill, that works as well. And finally, you have lines. So what's lines? Well, it's just going to animate the whole line. So if you have something that's a lot, like subscribe, and let's say I'm just going to space 3, and then I'm going to copy this, let's say 5 times. That looks like that, and then I'm going to adjust the scale so it looks like this. What lines will do is it's actually going to animate line by line, which is pretty cool. And you can get creative with this. If you want to stack the layers and then go to your background layer and increase the size and the rotation and then the opacity to like 5, you can do that as well, because you can start to get some crazy effects when you stack these on top of each other. So now that we've done that, there is another little thing right here. So there's this animation fade. If you drag that up, watch what happens. You'll start to notice that the animation actually fades in a little bit. So it's kind of like it fades in, which is cool. And it looks very different on different ones, depending on what you do. I think characters excluding spaces is where you can see it the most. Like if you don't have a lot, you'll see that the letters actually start to fade in. And then one of my favorite features is the randomize function. So when you do the randomize function, it kind of like pops in all over the place, which is really cool. And you're noticing that this MOGRT isn't heavy on your computer. Like it's playing and previewing at full really fast. In essence, that's pretty much everything. You kind of just have to get creative with what you want to create. Now let's show you how to actually make this within After Effects. But first, I want to let you guys know that I've redesigned my product page so you can see everything that I have to offer, because I realize that a lot of people don't think that all my products are free. Most of them are free, and I have a couple that are paid, aka two. Now, when you go to something and it says like, oh, it's $5, well, that's because there is something in here that you have to watch the video to get the discount code. And I'm slowly moving all my products to the way that this video was done, so you don't have to actually watch the whole video. I just really appreciate a like and subscribe. So yeah, you can hover over all these things, see what they have, and then go through here and just download all these free ones at your heart's desire. All right, once you open up After Effects, all you have to do is click the Create New Composition button down here, and you can name it whatever you want. So we'll do Outline, Verse, Fill, Tut for tutorial. And then I'm going to make the duration 1 second because we're going to build this with responsive design. I'm actually going to close the Essential Graphics window because we don't really need that right now. First things first, right-click down here in the timeline and go to New Text, and then we're going to name this whatever we want, Kyler Holland. Now, what I like to do is actually center my anchor point. So After Effects actually has a wonderful center anchor point. So if you just type in anchor, then you'll see this thing called lock anchor point. Drag that onto your text layer, and then in the effects controls window, make sure it's on middle center. That'll just make sure that your text is aligned to the very middle of your composition. Let's just adjust the size. So click S, you can adjust the scale of this text so it looks good, and double click on your text layer and pick a font that you like. I'm gonna stick around with this one. Your text should look like this, but what we're gonna do is over here in the properties, uncheck the fill layer and then check the one below it, which is our stroke layer, and I set the stroke to 5. So now we have everything set up and we're ready to start animating. All you have to do is click this drop down arrow, click this button next to animate, and then go up to fill color and opacity. Once you do that, it's going to change our thing to a fill, and you'll see that we have this range selector, the fill opacity we can animate. But if we just drop down this range selector a little bit and then drop down the advanced tab, you'll see that we have a ton of different options. For example, if we drag the end to the left, you'll see that it's taking our animation away. Now, play around with all these because these all basically give you everything that you can manipulate, and we're going to make an essential graphics out of this. So, if we drag the start up now, you'll see that it starts from the start and it animates forward. But this based on, we can change how it animates. So we can animate it by words, and you'll also see that it's fading in. That's due to the smoothness. So if I drag the smoothness all the way down, you'll see that it's just a hard stop right away. All right, so that's pretty much everything that you need to know. That's the effect. It's super simple, and I told you this was easy. A couple other things that you need to know is what I'm gonna get into, and this is where the tutorial may get a little bit more complicated. Let's head up to Window and then open up Essential Graphics. Select your composition name, and then you can do this thing that says solo supported properties. So once you do that, in down in your timeline area, it's gonna solo everything that you can bring into the Essential Graphics window. So for example, I'm gonna start off by bringing in the source text. So this source text allows you to change everything. So motion graphic. And just like that, it changed. And then you can click edit properties, so you can enable Fox styles or custom font selection, just like so. And now let's start getting a little bit more complicated. We haven't really animated anything. So what I need to do is add a keyframe at the start and then head over here towards the end and make this 100%. And I'm going to drag that keyframe out all the way to the end. So now we have an animation that goes from the start to the finish, and we can change how it works. So all of these things can be dragged into the top. So you can do based on characters, you can change the smoothness, so that will adjust like the fade, and you can bring in the randomized order, so then it like goes crazy. And then there's a couple other things, but I may make that for a new tutorial, like creating drop downs and like checkboxes and stuff. So if you want a video on that, let me know. But I'm gonna keep this tutorial nice and short. The final thing you'll need to do to make this work and scale it with responsive design is simply head up to composition and down to responsive design, create an intro, and then composition, responsive design, create an outro. Now what I like to do, and this is kind of just my technique, is bringing it all the way to the start and making it one frame. And whenever you do that, for some reason this one doesn't actually drag out like that. You actually have to drag the ending of it into one frame and then drag the start to your end. What this does is it will actually protect this region, and then everything in the middle can scale. So all of this animation that's happening in the middle will actually scale with your motion graphic. Once you add all your settings and you play around with it and change the naming, all you have to do is name this whatever you want and then click Export Motion Graphics Template. Once you do that, you can save it to wherever you want and import it into Premiere Pro. Well, hopefully you guys enjoyed that tutorial, and if you did, please let me know down in the comments below. Hit that like button and consider subscribing, because I'm going to be making some more stuff in the future. I'll see you guys next time.